The RSL has slammed the plan to hold a rock concert in the CBD during Anzac Day commemorations at Martin Place. Premier Chris Minns has now pulled the pin, forcing festival organisers to find a new venue.
The city filled with songs of soldiers past. Thousands fill the streets to salute our veterans. The most sacred day on our calendar, and this year it could be competing with this. A rock festival organised less than a kilometre away in the Domain, due to start as the post-march commemorative ceremony at the Pool of Remembrance finishes. The RSL wants it shut down and the Premier agrees.
A rock concert in the middle of the CBD on Anzac Day can't go ahead, and we won't allow it to go ahead.
You've got the football up the road. Is that disrespecting the Anzac? East and St George go head to head, 40,000 people. So what's the difference between sports entertainment and music entertainment on Anzac Day?
Pandemonium features 13 international artists, including Blondie, Deep Purple and Alice Cooper. The East Coast tour has been in the pipeline for 6 months, and organisers say they can't change the date.
Well, I thought we ticked all the boxes, and I would have hoped that through the support we're giving through Wounded Heroes, and have done so in the past, and through Legacy, that it shows that we're legitimately sincere in our efforts and our thoughts with the returned servicemen.
The organisers are now in talks with the state government negotiating a relocation, with the concert most likely to be held here at Olympic Park. But the 11th hour overhaul won't come cheap.
Obviously there'll be an enormous financial burden there.
Lesson learned from the New South Wales government. I'm sorry that it's gone this far.
Sophie Upcroft, Nine News.